A day after Times Now's End VVIP Raj campaign, Civil Aviation Ministry has decided that the privilege of taking a car up to the tarmac will be granted to only those who deserve it as per protocol. While speaking to Times Now, MOS Civil Aviation Mahesh Sharma has said that the process of delisting has already begun and has promised immediate action.
We're now joined by the Minister of State for Civil Aviation, Mr. Mahesh Sharma. Sir, first and foremost, the big question that I have to ask you is about, you know, VVIP privileges, particularly as far as airport entry, car vehicle entry into the tarmac is concerned. A large number of leaders, even after demitting office, where they are entitled to such privileges, continue to enjoy it. How does the Ministry of Civil Aviation look at this? Do you propose to take some action on these leaders?
No, this process has already started. As per protocols, only those people who deserve this, and as per protocol, they need it, they will be given. All another people, irrespective of any party, irrespective of government or non-government, they will be delisted, and the process has already started. I think in the national security interest and the wider interest of the aviation industry, this issue should be beyond any reservations of any party or person.
Sir, a lot of people continue to claim this privilege on medical grounds. But the big question is that, you know, end of the day, a number of people are old age, a number of people may have physical disabilities, a number of people may have ill health. Will they all be allowed this kind of access?
No. We will see it on priority. There is a clear indication from our ministry side that no privileges, no priorities to be given on the basis of flimsies and fancies or on anybody's VIP or non-VIP. They will be purely considered on merits and as per protocols and laws permitted by the civil aviation. There is a clear guidelines, and the process of delisting of such people has already started.
How soon can we hope to see action, sir?
You will see that we have started all the processes, especially in my three ministries, in a time frame manner. Whenever we define a problem, dedicate a person, and we define it in a time frame manner, that this is the time frame, and we declare it on that date that by this date we'll be completing this target.
So can you give us a time frame, sir?
See, I think I'll not comment it here, but this process has already started and our officers has already given.
Madhav Dasgopalakrishnan, who was speaking to the minister there, now joining us live. Madhav, action coming in after Times Now's campaign, and the minister there saying that the process of delisting has already started. However, he did not really share a time frame.
Well, yes, absolutely. The ministry not yet giving any kind of time frame, but only assuring that certainly they have taken notice. It was Times Now that it first brought out these shocking details as far as the Ministry of Civil Aviation is concerned. Clearly, of course, several union ministers and chief ministers, long after demitting office, continuing to enjoy this perk, particularly where they could really take their car right up to the tarmac. Clearly, of course, this is something that is not allowed as per the rules, and the Ministry of Civil Aviation now taking notes, saying that only those who are allowed as per the rules will be permitted to take their car right up to the tarmac. So clearly, the Ministry of Civil Aviation taking note of Times Now's report and thus taking action. It will be delisting several of the individuals on that list. We will, of course, have to wait and see what action finally takes place on ground, whether this is just lip service or whether some kind of actual measure is taken by the government. Because clearly, of course, when the entire public discourse has been focused around ending the Lal Bat culture, ending the VVIP culture, clearly, of course, this government cannot be seen to be promoting it at any level.
Absolutely, Madhav. And also, what are you hearing from your sources within the ministry on the fresh demands that had come in from MPs? There were demands of a nodal officer, also behavioral training to CISF jawans who handle VIPs at the airport. So what's the response of the ministry to that?
Well, the ministry is very clear that as far as this entire set of demands is concerned, this is not something that is going to be entertained. Clearly, of course, there already is a nodal officer who is in place. But clearly, the new set of demands that have been made by the members of parliament is not something the ministry is likely to accept in terms of granting more privileges. For instance, it was being said that they should be allowed entry without showing the ticket if they just show their member of parliament I-card.
Yes.
But clearly, of course, in today's security scenario, that is not something that is acceptable or will be at any cost permitted, is what the ministry has said.
The Times Now campaign has generated a massive response across the nation, with people calling us and telling us unacceptable instances of VVIP high-handedness. But the ministers and ex-ministers who have been using the runway like their personal property still don't want to let go of the privileges. For some, it's common courtesy. For the others, it's medical condition. But the question we are asking is, if people like you and me can line up in queues, can take the bus and can walk up to the aircraft despite having a medical condition, then why why should these special privileges be extended to these politicians?
We had a question to you about VVIP facilities and you being given the...
I think it was highly unfair what your channel did yesterday. Okay. I categorically said that we have not asked for these facilities. You have told me about it. I need to look at that order. And I think it's unfortunate how it was out of proportion. As you see, I have my own private car for the last 6 years. I do not take a sarkari car, forget about a lal batti. So where is the question about me asking that give me special privileges? Anyone who's seen me travel, I travel by whatever conveyance everybody else goes by. So I suggest that instead of just arriving suddenly and asking a person something, like I said, give me time. You have told me something, I know nothing about it. If the aviation ministry has put out something like that, I am not in the know-how about it. But it was unfortunate that you decided to make a big news about it.
Dr. Karan Singh, this particular permission, you're one of those in the 17 list who is allowed the vehicle. Sir, on what basis has this been given? On what grounds has this been given?
First of all, I'm 84 and I have this physical disability for many years. I've had a stiff hip for 60 years, in fact. And as I grow older, it becomes a little difficult to walk. So this was a courtesy extended to me, I think. I was also previous an aviation minister. I don't know whether that counted or not. I was a cabinet minister, I don't know whether that counted or not. I was an ambassador, I don't know whether that counted. I don't really know. I think it was a collection of various factors. They extended the courtesy to me.
Sir, as per the rules, as per the BCCS notifications, it's allowed for cabinet ministers when they are in office. But after demitting office, is it justified to retain this sort of a privilege, sir?
You see, the thing is that until the 18th of August this year, I was president of the ICCR, which had a cabinet rank. Even now, after demitting that office, I am chairman of the Auroville Foundation, also with cabinet rank. So I do have cabinet rank, not in the cabinet, but I do have cabinet rank, and it's a sort of general courtesy extended to me.
Right. So the larger question I'm talking about is that when public discourse has been centered around ending the lal batti culture in the country, the fact is that there are several people who may have disabilities, who may have ill health. You know, shouldn't this, by this logic, be extended to all those persons as well who may be of a certain age, who may have certain kinds of disabilities?
I think there are some provisions. They're provided with wheelchairs or if there's a stretcher case. That's an emergency case. A stretcher case would be an emergency case.
Certainly not cars on the tarmac, sir.
Sorry?
Certainly not the cars being allowed on the tarmac.
I don't think so. But they are allowed into, they are given some special facilities. It's very difficult to, I suppose, lay down a general rule. But in my case, it is a facility they have given. I use it very rarely because nowadays there are aero bridges. This was really at a time when there were not aero bridges. And you had to get out of the thing and get onto a bus and then walk and walk and walk. Now there are aero bridges. Aero bridges, it is not operative. It is only operative in those areas where there are no aero bridges. Where, you know, there may be a long walk before you get to the terminal.
You know, one instance is VIPs being allowed to drive right up to the tarmac. Your father is one of those people who have been allowed to drive right up to the tarmac. Do you feel that this is really a violation of the fact that, you know, MPs and ministers are also Aam Aadmis and they should also be behaving like the Aam Aadmi?
See, I mean, these are policies matters. I mean, I think everyone comes under the law.
But why would your father be given such a special privilege?
I have no clue about that. I think my father will be the best person to answer your question. But yes, it's something which is not as per the law should not happen. I was that absolutely.
So do you think that this is a misuse of VVIP facilities?
I have no clue whether it's the misuse of VVIP facilities or whether he's a very, very, very senior and a seasoned politician. You know, he's been in the house for years now. He's got a 45 years career behind him, active political career behind him. So yes, as per seniority, certain privileges are given. I think that's pretty all right. But then yes, nobody is over the law. If there's any kind of a violation of the law, that should really be looked into.
So while Chirag Paswan seems to believe his father deserves the privilege because he is a senior politician, Ram Vilas Paswan himself is ready with the medical condition excuse. Let's listen into what he told us.
VVIP culture पे सर काफी किया जा रहा है, काफी बातें चल रही है कि जिस सरकार आई थी इस प्रॉमिस पे कि लाल बत्ती कल्चर को एंड करेंगे. सर, कई नेताओं को जो है एयरक्राफ्ट तक एक्सेस मिलती है गाड़ियों की. सर, किस आप भी उनमें से एक हैं. सर, किस
नहीं, वो हेल्थ के ग्राउंड पर मिलता है. जिनको हार्ट का प्रॉब्लम है या मरने के है
तो वो हेल्थ के ग्राउंड पर मिलता है, इसे सबको नहीं मिलता है।
सर बट ये वैलिड है क्या सर आज के डेट में जब आप इसके एंड करने की बात कर रहे हैं?
Madhav continues to be with us. And Madhav, look at the excuses. For some of them, it's something that is available and so they use it. Some say they are senior citizens. Some say they have medical ailments. But what these excuses really reveal is a mindset that needs to be fought against and changed.
Well, absolutely. And that's really the part of our entire campaign. That's the focus of our entire campaign. That really, of course, though there may be on paper reasons such as medical or security, the point is that there are clear violations of the law when they are out of power. Clearly, all of these leaders are not allowed to have this kind of an access as per the rules. And that is really the big question at this point of time. Even when we talk about medical grounds, if clearly they can be seen walking around at their respective offices or around parliament, clearly what is the great difference? Difficulty in accessing a plane like rest of the citizens do at the airport. That is really the big question that we are trying to pose, and really what is the need for this particular privilege. Of course, if there is a security ground on which someone is looking at this in terms of their entire threat, then and the MHA has recommended it, then it is an altogether different matter. But very often what we are seeing is that this medical ground that has been given is something that has really been abused time and again, as so also with the entire security ground. Lalu Prasad Yadav, for instance, being given the entire security ground, but at the same time, he's a person who cannot even contest an election, but now has a permission to drive his car right up to the tarmac. So really, of course, is a huge disjunction over there between his legal status and between the kind of privileges and perks that he does enjoy. Also, the permission that was given to him was after the period that he was union minister. So several questions that have that can be raised as far as why he was given this permission in the very first place. And it's not just Lalu or Paswan, but 17 such names that we have brought out, and several of those really who are part of this entire violation.
Well, it's a status symbol, Madhav, that they don't want to let go of, but the campaign is bringing about change. After Times Now's campaign, we have seen the Civil Aviation Ministry now stepping in and saying that they have